If I take away the free throw line, will you still love me? I don't think James Harden will. There's been like a lot of talk about who's the most offensive player ever in NBA, who's the toughest to guard in NBA, who's the most unstoppable in NBA. And James Harden's name comes up a lot, you know, especially with his recent stint of 40-point games. Everybody is saying that the way that he plays within the rules is basically tough to guard him, and he has to be the most unguardable player in the NBA. And I disagree with that notion 100%. Because James Harden's game is predicated on getting fouled. He goes to the line an abundant amount of times. Last game he went to the line 22 or 27 times. He shot, if you're shooting 10 plus free throws every single game, you're going to get within the 30s range, point blank period. Like, it's hard to get 10 plus free throws a game. James Harden does that on that. He's averaged that. His game is predicated on getting fouled. Once he gets fouled, he goes to the line. He gets the other team's best defender in foul trouble. And there goes the net, because teams are scared to foul him. So now he has more room to operate and shoot threes. If you do not foul James Harden, he will not go off for all these 40-point games. James Harden lives at the line. Therefore, if you take away the free throw line, his game is done. Because all he does is drive to the basket for layups and step back threes. If you're not fouling him on either one of those, or you cut that in half, his offensive efficiency decreases dramatically, which was shown in the 2016 playoffs, I believe, the San Antonio Spurs. James Harden basically was a no-show. Then if you looked at all the playoffs where the Warriors got them in the first round, second round, they did the same thing to Harden, basically contest without fouling, just play him without fouling, and guess what happened? The Rock, you got to remember, last year was the first time the Rockets really made it really, really far in the playoffs. You know, and the last 2 years prior to that, they weren't going anywhere because teams figured out if we don't foul James Harden, we're good. So all you have to do as an offensive player is not foul the guy, which is easier said than done, I understand. But just because you get to the free throw line a lot and you get fouled a lot doesn't mean you're hard to guard. Because what James Harden does a lot is a lot of flopping, a lot of flailing in the players and stuff like that. When I think of somebody hard to guard, I think of somebody with like an unstoppable move. And then when I think about their unstoppable move, I think about once you stop their move, they got another trick in the bag. And once you stop that trick in the bag, they got another trick in the bag. Once you stop that other trick in the bag, they're going to plan D. So they went from plan A, B, C, D. Oh, they got another hat check out the bag. They go to plan E. When you look at somebody like James Harden, if you look at his game, you see that he's a three-point shooter. You take away the three-point shot, now you make him a driver. He's a pretty good finisher with the left hand because he's left-handed, but he's not a really great finisher with the right hand. Now, let's just say you bottle up his drive and you just make him a three-point shooter. And they're all contested threes, but you're not fouling. Now we're talking something else, because James Harden only has two things. He switches gears on you, shifty, three-point layups. That's it. He doesn't have a post-up game. He doesn't have a back-to-the-basket game. He doesn't have a mid-range. He doesn't have like a solid, like a really, really big mid-range game. Like, he can shoot the mid-range, no doubt. But he's not like a mid-range person like a Kevin Durant, a Kobe Bryant, a Michael Jordan. So he's very guardable. It's just the rules and the way that he plays, the way that he draws fouls, is why people think he's so unguardable. But at the end of the day, the real people that are unguardable, the Michael Jordans, the Kobes, the Kevin Durants, doesn't matter if you foul them. They're still making a basket. They don't rely on the referees to bail them out. Look, James Harden relies on referees to bail him out, which will and could be his potential downfall in this upcoming playoffs. You can't rely on referees to bail you out. And that's what, to me, doesn't make him unstoppable, because he is relying on the referees to officiate the game a certain way for him to win. The great scorers and the most unguardable guys, they don't care how the game is officiated. They're going to still do what they got to do to score and win. Harden is completely opposite. He's waiting on that bailout. He's waiting on his stimulus package from the referees. He's waiting on that whistle. He plays for the whistle. The most unguardable guys play through the whistle. Sort of like with LeBron James, more than athlete, he alluded to this after the game six win or whatever the case is against the Golden State Warriors. He was like, they effed up. They mentally effed up. And that's what happens to James Harden, because you all remember the 2016 finals. The Warriors were kind of mentally disheveled because of the suspension, but also because the way the game was getting officiated. It was a lot more physical. They didn't call as much things. In the playoffs, they're not going to call all them fouls, ticky-tack fouls that they call on James Harden in the regular season. That mentally messes him up. It messes him up. And this is why we get these weird games where he scores 15. That's why we get these game sevens where he's missing a bunch of threes, where those step backs aren't working anymore. Because he's relying on the officials. Like, you can't say, oh, like, he's so unguardable. He's so unguardable. What happens when the refs swallow their whistle? Is he still unguardable? I don't think so. So, to me, unguardable means that whistle or no whistle, you're unguardable. Free throws or no free throws, you're unguardable. Somebody like, you look at Kevin Durant. Yeah, if he's not getting free throws, he's getting to the basket. If he's not getting to the basket, he's shooting the three. If he's not getting shooting three, he's shooting the mid-range. He has a turnaround, Jay. Look at Michael, Kobe, turnaround, Jay. Post up. Mike and Kobe could hit a three. They didn't have the highest percentage, but they could hit threes. They could hit mid-range. They could post you up. They could take the small guy on the block. You know, they could drive by up a bigger guy. Like, those guys are T-Mac. Those guys are really hard to guard because you're fouling them. You putting a forearm on them. You're doing everything to them, and it doesn't matter. KD shooting over you like a chair. That's what's really unguardable. I think his streak is impressive. His numbers are impressive, but it's not necessarily because he's unguardable. It's because he is cheating. He's manipulating the rules so he could get to the free throw line, so he could up his points. And once you get to the free throw line, with Shaq proved, fouling guys out, you change the defense. So it's not necessarily that he's unguardable. It's just he has the assistance of the officiating. Once the assistance of officiating goes down, or the handicap, or whatever you call it, once that gets evened out during the playoffs, well, now we're going to start talking about what happened to James Harden, which I hate to hear it, but I warned you guys earlier in the season. Hoops Junction, where hoops meets hoopla. Like, comment, subscribe.